Blizzard is letting you and you and you. Yes, they're letting everybody. Everybody can vote on a bunch of GSL maps to be featured in the Season 7 map pool. To give us a better amount of information, we have Cal2 on the line. Cal, so the latest season we had Blizzard add player maps. Why are they not making them themselves like they have in previous seasons?
Well, if you look at the recent season's maps, they've all kind of sucked a little bit. If you look at the most successful maps have been around since like Season 1, like Shakura's Plateau, like Metalopolis, they're all really, really old maps, and they're the real gems that Blizzard have created. I mean, in previous seasons, they've made one or two maps that people like Antigua Shipyard, and recently Entombed Valley, but it just seems that some of their maps just aren't good enough compared to other maps, say like the ones that have been added recently, like Cloud Kingdom. Everyone loves Cloud Kingdom, and that was a player-made map, so Blizzard just aren't keeping up with the quality of maps.
Now, Tal'Darim Altar was a massive success since it was added in the previous GSL. Are they just sticking with previous successes here?
Well, yeah, when Tal'Darim Altar was added to the map pool, everyone loved it because it's a brilliant map. Everyone still loves it. Everyone loves the fact that it's just so dynamic, it's so large. But at the same time, it's not like anything like a Terminus or something like that. It's just such a nice map. And so Blizzard probably looked back at the four, and they looked at the last two seasons and thought, right, people didn't really like it when we added all these new maps. I mean, yeah, they liked Antigua, yeah, they liked Entombed, but the other two maps, they didn't even like it, so why should we even waste the manpower in creating two maps that will take ages to do if we just go around the world and we just say, oh, look, hey, we did really well with Tal'Darim from the GSL, why don't we just look at all the GSL maps now, like Belshire Beach, like all of the other ones, and then just turn around and say, you know what, let's just let them have one of these, one or two of these.
Now, as I understand, you actually have a few personal issues with these maps. Can you elaborate on that?
Well, it's something that I've been noticing really recently, is the evolution of the game is taking this really big step towards, everyone seems to want to take a natural on the third base as quickly as possible to get a better economy. If you look back at the original Blizzard maps, I'm not saying they were better because some maps were absolutely terrible, but the smaller maps, they're so much better because you'd have to take a risk to take that third base. You'd have to take a risk sometimes to even take your natural, and you'd have to tech up and stuff like that. And it just added a little bit of flavor. Like, if you look at all these GSL maps, if you look at like Calm Before the Storm and Terminus, they have really, really easy natural bases to take, and then it basically funnels you into the third base, and your opponent just can't get at your third base or your second base apart from one choke point, and it takes the diversity out of the map because you know that you can take those three bases on this map.
Sure, it's not an element of risk in trying to get that extra stronghold.
Exactly. Like, one map that I absolutely hate is Calm Before the Storm, because your natural is adjacent to your map, and there's no other way for the enemy to get up it apart from a 4-block-wide ramp into your main base. They've got to go through your main base to get to your natural, and it's like, before, there should be a risk to take your natural. Like, if you look back at previous maps like Typhoon Peaks, I mean, loads of people didn't like it, but I just missed the fact that there was, if you look at the third base, there's like four different ways to get at it, like round the back through destructible debris. And it just added a little bit more flavor, knowing that you knew, because now you know where people are coming from. But back then, it'd be like, oh my god, are they going to attack from this way? Are they going to attack from that way? It's just taking away the diversity from the map pool. So I really, really hope everyone votes for Belshire Beach and Jewel Site, because I don't want one of these big maps. I want one of the smaller maps.
Well, guys, now is the time to let your voice be heard. You get to shape the way and the maps that will be featured for Season 7, so make sure that your voice is heard. For all of your gaming news, keep it tuned right here to Game Breaker TV. See you next time.